Sequence Z, we now talk to Manik Kurukulasoorya, the actress, the film star. Manik, we go back to 1973, to Pattiraja's Ahas Gauwa. That was your first entry into cinema. Now, you entering film, is it because your sisters were actresses or because they wanted you for you?
I think they wanted me because I was my sister's, but for that particular role, they wanted a little girl, so who was just growing up, you know, going to school. So I think I suited the thing.
No colors for your sister.
They were easy. It was easy to approach me because yeah. I was who I was.
Yes.
Because I was the sister's.
Sister.
Yeah, sister. So yes.
And then there was Senekelia in 1973.
Yes, both I did at the same time.
Okay. Then and you went back to school.
I didn't want to continue. Movies because I want to study and I was brainwashed not to act and, and not to do any of these things. Maybe I started too young also and I was not like mature enough to understand anything.
But did
so
you,
I just went
did
by
as,
whatever.
Did you as Manik wanted to be an actress? Sisters were?
Well, those days we never thought of professions. We just grew up, you know. We just, nobody, those days at my time. Only right after me, I think. At my time, we were not told you have to have a career, you have to be professional. Otherwise, if I was very good in my studies and I would have been pursued, you know, in that way.
See, even your sisters, they acted, they quit. And
yeah,
they
that's because my sister was dancing and singing from small days and she loved all these things. Then also Lest Uncles happened to be. So she got into it because of that. She acted in a play and then she was invited, like that. So then, for me also, it was not like as a career that I'm going to do for a long time or, you know, this is I'm going to be my path. And when I was growing up, all my sisters were getting married and giving up the at the height of their, popularity.
Yes,
my sisters all got there. Married and gave up acting and all that. So it was not a big thing for me. I didn't think of it as a lifelong career.
Were you the replacement for your sisters on the single silver screen? See, you all looked alike, especially Janaki and you. You know, you look alike and the same skin tone, the same color, all that.
Well, I don't know. Similar and different also.
Yes. So 2 years later came The God King in 75.
Yeah.
Your relative, Dr. Lester James Pierce, right?
Yes.
What is the connection?
Actually, he's a cousin of my father. He's also a Kurukulasoorya, if you know, a gay. So our name was also Gay, you know, Kurukulasoorya Gay, and my father's
name,
that is.
Yes,
family name was Kurukulasoorya. So he put it at the end for us from the beginning, not for the films, but from school days. I was called Hyacinth also, by the way, because All Saints and all that was a Christian school. Yeah, so they only knew me by Hyacinth. Then later on, only I became my second name, Manik, was used at St. Paul's and. After that,
Dr. Pierce's first death anniversary is next Monday. Manik, what would be your fondest memory, you in God King, your fondest memory of Lester James Pierce?
Oh God, he was such a gentle, quiet, you know, being, you know, that was a very big production. But the way he handled it, we never heard his voice, never spoke loud. And he used to explain things very softly. And he was such a gentleman, you know. So, and also I remember my birthday, my 16th birthday came.
You were shooting?
Yes. Okay. I was 15 when I was doing it. Then after that, it was at the end of, that was actually the last day of the shoot in Vijay Studios. And then suddenly, everybody wished me, all these foreign people were acting in it. So in the morning they all wished me and all that. In the evening, suddenly after the shoot, happy birthday to you. And he was like the main organizer, Miss Pierce and Mr. Pierce. So, and all these stars, they had contributed and they had made it a special birthday gift for me. And it was very pleasant, you know.
The film that made you a household name, I think, was Chandran Ratnam's Adara Kathava.
Yes.
The Sinhala Girl and the Tamil Boy.
Yes.
That was huge. Right? It took you to everybody's hearts.
Yes, I think so. I think that is actually mainly it went to all these schoolgirls and boys who loved it. Now I meet them and they still keep asking me about that. Out of the movies I did, that's the only one I won a little award for. And also it went to the New Delhi Film Festival and came into the last 10 out of about 350 movies, and it's the best one. Now there are so many awards ceremonies all over the world, but this is like the main one in India. And so coming into the last 10 was a good thing, and I got to present myself.
Who committed suicide? He or you?
Me.
You.
Yeah.
Yeah. With
yeah. That time it was great, but now I would not encourage any.
What were fans like at that time? What was fan mail?
God.
There was no texting, there was no internet.
No. All letters. And then some people just come home, just stand around the house.
Yes. How did you handle all that?
Oh God, it was very difficult because I was alone.
But they love you, that's why they came to see you.
Yeah, I know, but it's genuine film fans and all. There are all kinds of people who come now. So it was a bit difficult, and having to answer the phones, and it was very difficult for me, and disturbing calls throughout the night. And sometimes they'll go and put the number in the papers or something. Oh my God, non-stop. So there were
What about nuisance calls?
Nuisance calls was a lot. So because of that,
the bulk calls.
Yeah, so because of that, I missed a lot of good opportunities because I was angry why they, you know, when I answered for a day, nobody else liked to.
So your brother Vivek could have taken the calls. He was so protective.
No, that was earlier. No, he left. He's a marine engineer, and he went for his job, and then he went to study in Australia. So he was not around to help me.
You recently.
He would have said, just stay at home.
Vivek, can you hear what
why do you do all these things? That's why you have to go through all that. You just stay at home.
Now, the most recent one was Sam's Story.
Yes.
That was a Gracian Award winner. What was that experience like?
Oh, that was also very nice because I did a movie after a long time. Actually, I had given up again, as usual. And then I came back with Samige Katha because I had read the book also. I read the book also, and then I liked it. And that's in English. The book is called Sam's Story. And this movie is Sami Katawa. And Priyankar Vitanarachi, he called me and spoke to me. And then this particular character really interested me. And by that time, you know, in my life, it has been a matter of where I am at the moment, you know. So that's, in my life, there are like different things happening. So when I was going to, I want to go to school, so I gave up. Then the next time when my parents died, then again I went to Babangi to Hetty, like that, you know. So it's been like that. So I was doing something else, and then there was a break in between, and then I was asked to do it, and then I felt, I'll like to do it. So and I did it, and it was a very great, nice experience because it was done very nicely and a beautiful location in Bolgoda. And I could relate to it, so.
Manik, my last question. How best do you want to be remembered one day? A standard question I ask everybody on the show, as you know. One day, many years later. How does Manik Kurukul Surya want to be remembered?
Okay. Nothing is forever, no? Nobody remembers you forever. Even the people you think you can't do without, or the biggest idols in this world are not remembered. Maybe like on a after a time, and maybe on a special day you remember them.
So how do you
How do I want to be remembered? I don't know. Let me see. Whatever I do, if I can make a positive impact in somebody's life, people's lives, and if that is what I would be like to remember, overcoming obstacles and challenges, and if I can strengthen people, give them light and knowledge. And I don't know, I would like to do some service. Maybe I'm just stuck now.
But you can do lots more. Thank you, Mary. Thank you so much. Nice talking to you. It was great
nice talking to you too.
To as well. And thank you, Cauldron, for hosting us here. The beautiful, the four-leaf clover, the popular Irish restaurant in the city of Colombo. We meet you again next week with another guest on another chat in another space.
Bye.